times.
Yeah. Meanwhile, I came to work today. It was sunny. An hour later, I walk out of a meeting, and it was a downpour. It was like driving rain here in Central Phoenix.
Oh, yeah. You know, you could kind of see it like rolling into the valley right around about 2 o'clock. Those darker gray clouds were kind of moving in, coming up from the south, and then it just was like boom and really just took off. So we're going to continue to see some isolated thunderstorms throughout the evening, some areas of some heavy rain, some lighter rain. But I wanted to talk a little bit about temperatures. And of course, we've definitely noticed those low-lying clouds that have been all around our mountains, giving us those beautiful shots. Yesterday in the 60s, today we were in the 70s, closer to where we should be as far as our afternoon temperature. Still, though, feels a little kind of balmy out there, very tropical due to the fact that we have a lot of that rain kicking up the humidity and the dew points. We'll expect those off and on showers through Friday night as the system is really finally moving into Arizona. Flood watches and warnings are in place for most of the areas that we have been already seeing some flooding that has been happening. Isolated thunderstorms bringing lightning, strong winds, heavy downpours expected possibly tonight into tomorrow. And then those snow levels as we head into our overnight hours, dropping to about 7,000 feet, but just kind of a dusting of snow, maybe a couple of inches when we're all said and done. This is more of a rain event. So Doppler radar definitely showing us we had a little bit of some light showers that moved through the valley. This was very light, most of this not making it to the ground just over the past hour, but the heavier showers that did move through now impacting Camp Verde, Sedona, Cottonwood, and moving into the Flagstaff area. We're also seeing those showers that have been pushing up into the Heber Overguard area that's still tracking your way and going to be coming in. And then we've had a very heavy rain. Lake Havasu getting reports of some flooding that is happening up there. You can see how those showers have been moving through. But look at this line, this band that's out in California. This is stretching from El Centro up through Blythe and is pushing to the east. So Yuma, Quartzsite, get ready. You're going to have some heavy rain. Definitely that's going to be coming your way. So I expect those showers to continue as that storm system, as you can see, is moving into Arizona. It should be right over the border of Arizona and California by 11 o'clock tonight, continuing to bring us those showers and heavier pockets of rain in northeastern Arizona heading into the start of the day tomorrow. Then it's just basically some spotty showers that will develop heading into Friday afternoon. So we'll still keep those chances for showers here in the valley. Temperature wise, we're going to drop those temperatures once again tomorrow back into those 60s. Then we've got 70s for the weekend as we dry out and continue to stay nice and dry as we head into our Monday. But another storm system is just right behind this one that will move through. We'll have that chance of showers beginning Tuesday night, going through Thursday night next week.
Weekend looks